What's your bit? Your resting bitch face. It's like this. But that doesn't mean like we're not happy. Look, I'm happy right now.
I think the funniest thing about us is that we met just a couple days ago officially. Yep. And on a music video set, which is actually a lot of pressure.
And it is very a little bit nerve-wracking because you're like, I don't know. Because it's a lot about like the vibe.
The chemistry.
Yeah. And I was like, I don't know. You know,
is she gonna like me?
Yeah.
Am I gonna like her?
Are we gonna be able to move that booty together?
Yeah.
And it was so high five.
That was a lot of fun. We did that.
That was fun.
When I heard that you loved the song and that you wanted to do your thing on it, I was like, relieved. I was like, she gets it, perfect. And then when we shot the video, I think it made it all the more clear that it was supposed to be this way. Like the best thing about this song is that it is so sexy and it's so empowering in a way where some people might feel
uncomfortable. It's real.
But I'm glad because I want people to think a little harder and accept that, you know, especially in Latin music, it's hard for people to accept that women can own their sexuality.
Oh, and we Latinas are very sexy. If you really see it, you see our moms, like, they're actually the ones running the whole situation.
Thing. Yeah, it comes from our culture, very deep rooted. The women, especially antes, era totalmente diferente. Like, there was this macho-ness going on where the man can go to work, the man can go fuck whoever he wanted to fuck, but mom had to stay home, and mom had to cook and clean, and mom had to take care of the kids, and iron dad's clothes.
And you know what? I think that since we grew up with that, we're like, no. Like, I didn't see myself just doing that.
Right.
But yeah, no. And I was like, I am not going to stay in the house because you want to work, and then where's my money? No, I think it's all about a balance. If they love us as women, then that means they want to see us grow.
Exactly. Exactly.
You know?
Yeah. So I think that's what I love so much about everything we've done for the song, including the music video. Yeah. I mean, my favorite part of the video is actually the end of the video. Because that is the real life. Like, when creating, like, the idea for the video, like, I really thought to myself, like, this can go so far into the whole sexy, which is what everybody wants us to be.
Yeah.
And I don't mind going there. I mean, this is for sure the first time people have seen me like this.
And it's a very natural thing. No, and it, at the end of the day, it's a natural thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you didn't try to be sexy.
Exactly.
It's there. I mean, you feel it. So that's why you express it.
I mean, look, I try. There's always going to be good and bad. And I think the one thing we learned a long time ago is not everybody's going to like you. And you're okay with that. I'm okay with that.
I'm super good.
It's all, I'm chilling. If there's anything that I'm thankful for, and I'm sure you've had similar experiences, for instance, with Benito, with Bunny.
Like, yeah, Bunny.
Literally.
He was very sweet.
So sweet.
Yeah.
So collaborative as well.
Yeah.
And like everybody else from Nikki to Balvin, everybody's just always like, even they talk about us in interviews, like shouting us out, like saying like they're doing their thing. Like they see us as equals. It's the industry itself and the public.
They like to do the competition.
That likes to like kind of just put us down here.
That is true.
And then put them up here.
Yeah.
Cause it's
and that's not the reality.
No.
It's
and
not.
I think we're definitely pioneers as far as changing that, especially with Piyama. I think people will be very surprised because for years we've seen Yankee, we've seen Fonzie, we've seen all the guys jumping on stage together,
and it looks
sharing
cool.
the light.
Yeah,
and like
it's a party. It feels like a party.
Yeah.
That's what a song is supposed to be. It's supposed to be fun.
I think we killed it with the video because people are gonna be like, "You went there," and be like, "But technically we did it."
But like, pay attention though.
Watch
is it
the
really
video.
There?
It's a it guy's fun. Fantasy. You know the amount of times on the acting side that like I get a script sent my way and in the character breakdown it says Latina and there's like sex scenes or whatever or girl on girl kissing and I'm like, what is this for? Like, is there a real story to this? Like, does it mean anything? And it's because it's these men writing these scripts it's like abuse of creative power, abuse of power overall to just like do stuff for their own guilty pleasures. But yeah. It's like,
yes,
I don't know if it's I'm with best, that. No. So playing with that and going there with saying, but that's not what it really is, by the way. I saw this meme. It was like, I like my coffee how I like my men.
Oh.
Silent.
Oh!
Because it doesn't talk.
I know, because when they talk, like, they mess it up. I like, you're putting yourself out there. I'm not even saying anything right now, you know?
And they're running around in circles, and you're like, okay, the lie's growing.
I'm like, well, you know, maybe you should show me your phone.
Maybe you're all about checking the phone. I don't know. You've said like 5 times. I was talking earlier.
No, you would never want to be. I'm lying. I'm playing. I'm very sweet and kind. Like at the beginning, you're like, oh, of course not. I'm not gonna look at your phone.
I'm not crazy.
If you don't look at my phone, I'm not gonna look at your phone. Mm-hmm. Okay. Same. But then like some time goes by and you're like,
who texted us?
The fuck is texting
you right now? Like, no, I always pick my head through his arms. I'm like, who's texting us?
Yeah, and you like, and you maneuver, you maneuver. You're like, I need to get some water. What the fuck is that? I saw that shit.
But that's the thing is, I ain't got nothing to hide.
That's good, you have nothing to hide.
No, Oh, I got a question. Do you like, are you the type to make the first move?
Usually.
Same.
Usually. I don't know if we like challenges sometimes. Cause like when they're like, oh my god, you're so beautiful and I would like love to like,
and I'm take
like,
you out and what's your number or whatever.
I'm like, I don't wanna do that. Mm-mm. I wanna chase you.
Yeah.
I wanna chase you.
I have a feeling you were bad. We're not that you were bad. You were just rebellious. You probably didn't like people telling you what to do.
I used to sneak out of my house to go sing in these really, really, really bad places. And I didn't care. I was like, can I sing first so I could just go home? But when I came back, I had the PJs outside, sing pajamas.
Oh my God.
I had the PJs outside. Yeah, mom
you
and dad.
You planned this. You were strategic.
I had to because it was a lot of fun going and singing. And it was reggaeton at that time in DR. Yeah. So that's why they saw it a little bit like my daughter is singing that, you know, and all that.
Yeah.
But it was a lot of fun because that's why I found a balance in being urban pop and saying things even in a double sense, but still saying what a woman wanted to say.
Right.
You know, but with a balance.
I feel like that is when you are, that's like the magic potion.
Yeah.
Because then nobody can tell you anything.
No.
Because you own it. You know what you're saying.
Yeah.
Like, que no me quepan la boca, los besos.
Listen to the song.
I'm talking about the kisses, homie. It ain't my fault what you're thinking. Yes. Like,
yeah,
hold up.
That is true.
But obviously, that's what I wanted you to think. You know what I mean? I remember I went to Spain and I was going to do a TV performance. And they're like, yeah, pero tenemos que cambiar las malas palabras. And I was like, in what part of the song do I say bad words? I'm not saying anything bad.
Yeah.
I already knew what they were gonna say, but tell me, I wanna hear you say it. What part of the song? Well, it's, you know, the que no me quepan la boca. It's just, it's gonna, and I'm like, guys, this is like.
Los besos. What are you listening to?
But not only that, like the song had been number one in Spain already for weeks.
That means they
loved
it.
Like weeks, which means the people, and I was like, fine. I'm gonna do it because I want to be respetuosa of the opportunity to do the show. But I bet you, and what happened, we were trending all through the whole country because everybody was like, this is so degrading to women, how sexist of them to have her change her lyrics.
But would they do that with guys?
No, that's what I was gonna say. If it was Ozuna, if it was Enrique.
I don't understand.
If it was anybody.
They let it be.
Do you think El Baño is about going pee-pee in the bathroom? No, it's about doing it in the bathroom, you know what I mean? But nobody has anything to say about that when it's a guy. But when we want to, you know, if a guy says, I want a lady in the streets but a freak in the sheets, like, hey, we kind of want the same thing.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Do.
We do, and we should be able to talk about that, you know? And so I think, as you can see, I get very angry about it because I'm like, my sexuality is me. You can't tell me what makes me feel sexy.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. I only can do one eyebrow.
But I could do it.
You could do both?
You want to see?
Yes.
Okay. It's like a wave thing.
How do you do that?
I don't know.
I can only do one.
I know there's a video for like when I'm two, and I'm like, what?
Just the wave. It's just like doing the
wave. But the one, if you get the one right, for all the pictures, it's like that one, it's two, three, it's like.